Hey everyone, hope you're having a great day so far. Wanted to hop on and talk to you guys about this. How to know if a quote-unquote gift was sent to you from the enemy or from God over your personal life today. And so I just want to walk you through some key signs that you usually see when the enemy tries to introduce counterfeit blessings into your personal life. And so first off, I wanted to talk about this. Contrary to popular belief, the devil loves to give quote-unquote gifts if it will distract you from your God purpose and get you off track with God's will for your life. But I want to tell you guys, those gifts will always come with a catch, and they will usually involve making you compromise at some point in the process. And the devil won't always show you this stuff up front. Sometimes the compromise will come years down the line. But I want to tell you guys that the devil's way always has a catch to it, okay? And so we can study the life of Jesus to study how the devil likes to hit us. Even as Christians, a lot of the time, this is not just unbelievers, this is Christians that the devil wants to hit. Because once you've given your life to Jesus, the devil's purpose then shifts to getting you off course with your God-given purpose that he has for your life, ladies and gentlemen, because he is terrified of you walking into your God destiny. He is terrified of purpose alignments and assignments on your life. And so if he can keep you distracted, if he can get you embracing counterfeit blessings in your life, which it can look like a lot of different things, then the devil wins over that situation, you know? And the devil does not mind giving gifts. Because, you know, if what's involved is just giving you a house, for example, you know, if that's what it'll take to get you distracted from God and not surrendering to the Lord in your life, he doesn't care. Sure, he'll give you a house. Because if it's giving you that house versus you spending an eternity in hell, the devil doesn't mind you getting that house. You know, our life is described in the Bible as like a vapor. You know, it happens like this, you guys. And so the enemy is not afraid to give you counterfeit blessings that will still cause you compromise. It will still be, you know, a little bit under what God has for you if it causes you to abort the entire destiny that's on your life. The devil has zero problem with that, you guys. He has zero problem with distracting you with a gift, quote unquote, if it keeps you away from God. And so I want to look at Matthew chapter 4 verses 1 through 11 today to study how Jesus was tempted in the wilderness. But one of the very first things that I want you to notice is about the timing of the temptation that hit Jesus's life, okay? So I want to tell you guys that the devil will often try to hit you with your counterfeit promise right before the real promise is about to come forth. We see this, and I want to read this to you guys in a second, where Jesus was about to be launched into his ministry. He was tempted in the wilderness right before his launch into full-time ministry with his life. And so when did the devil attack him? Right before he was supposed to be launched, right? Right before that gift, quote-unquote, you know, that calling that God had on Jesus's life was about to manifest and come forth. And so I think it's critical for us to watch out for distractions from the enemy, especially because distractions often come before breakthrough, ladies and gentlemen, and they come to try to get you off track. They come to try to gear you off course a lot of the time, and distractions rarely look like distractions until they are finished distracting you. Can I say that again? Distractions rarely look like distractions until they are finished distracting you, which is why we have to use extreme discernment. You need to listen to friends and family, you know, and you need to stay grounded in your prayer life and in the Word of God on a regular basis, because God will show you the warning flags if you're tuned in. But if you're not, if you're just looking at what you're seeing and feeling in the natural, you can miss it so easily, ladies and gentlemen. And so I want us to really break this down today. And then we'll go over some bullet points on signs that it's often sent by the enemy versus a blessing that's sent from God over your personal life. So let's check this out together. So let's start with Matthew 4, verse 1. It says, "Then Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights afterward, he was hungry. Now, when the tempter came to him, he said, 'If you are the Son of God, command that these stones become bread.' But he answered and said, 'It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.' Then the devil took him up to the holy city, set him at the pinnacle of the temple, and said to him, 'If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down, for it is written, He shall give his angels charge over you, and in their hands they shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. Jesus said to him, it is written, you shall not tempt the Lord your God. Now, those are the first two temptations. I want to pause here for a second. I've got a good teaching on this on my YouTube channel if you want to get the dive in on this fully, but I'm not going to focus on those two today. I want to focus on this third and final temptation because it has to do with receiving counterfeit gifts from the enemy over our lives. And if Jesus was tempted with it, you better believe that the enemy is going to try to get us with this in our personal lives, which is why we have to be careful. All right, third temptation, starting in verse 8. It says, again, the devil took him up on an exceedingly high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their glory. And he said to him, all these things I will give you if you will fall down and worship me. Then Jesus said to him, away with you, Satan, for it is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only will you serve. Then the devil left him, and behold, angels came and ministered to him. So I also don't want to focus this much. I've also got a teaching where it talks about how we fight the devil when he tries to come against us with this stuff. It's a good teaching on my YouTube. And basically, we need to stand on the word of God and what it says, and on the God promise, okay? But today, I want to focus on how the devil tried to hook Jesus into believing the lie and into a place of compromise via this particular temptation. So notice, the devil took him up on a high mountain where he could see everything, okay? And what did he do? He showed Jesus all the kingdoms of the world and their glory. In other words, he made it look flashy. He made it look easy. He pointed out all the good stuff. He didn't point out the bad stuff that would come afterwards. He just pointed out the good. And he said to him, all these things I will give you if you will fall down and worship me. So the devil was like, there's a catch. You know, you can get it easy. You can get it quick. It's very appealing to your eyes. It's very appealing to your flesh. Your flesh is going to get satisfied very easily, very quickly if you do things my way. But you got to fall down and worship me. And the way that this happens in our lives a lot of the time is the devil will offer you these counterfeit blessings. And it can look like a bunch of different things in your life. But there's always a catch. The devil will say, if you settle for something that's not the God promise, if you settle in a place of compromise for your life. You know, ladies and gentlemen, this is why it's so important, our stance of obedience in our lives. Because what you obtain in a place of compromise in your life, you then have to sustain it from a place of compromise for years down the line in your life. And so this is why the devil wants you pulled into these counterfeit blessings, is because it locks you into a place of counterfeit. It locks you into a place of compromise in your life for years to come. And that, my friends, is what aborts destiny. That's what, you know, can cause severe damage to the purpose that God is trying to draw forth from your life, because the enemy will send these quote-unquote distractions, which are really destiny killers a lot of the time in our life. And, you know, praise God that he is a redeemer and that he can help to get us off track, but a lot of times it can do a ton of damage in our lives if we are not very, very careful. And, you know, sin has consequences, ladies and gentlemen. And so it's not to say that this is not without consequences. When we choose, you know, the easy and quick quote-unquote blessings that are filled with compromise that the devil wants to send us versus what God wants to send. Now, the devil's not stupid. He knows that if he sent us something that outright looked really bad, that we would not fall for this, okay? So what he does is he'll send you something that mostly looks good, that mostly looks like it could come from God, but there's always just a little bit of something there where you know that it's not quite right. And so that's how the devil gets us. He knows that we're not stupid. He knows that if he just flat out presented us with something that's not of the Lord, that we would take a stand against it. So he's subtle. What he does is he causes us to question things slowly in our life. He causes us to slowly get introduced to the thing that's of him, that's not of the Lord. And before you know it, it's just like a fish hook. It hooks you, you know? And so you can't continue to play with this stuff and not expect to get hooked in your personal life. So let's look at some characteristics of sometimes how blessings in our lives come from the enemy rather than coming from God, and characteristics of blessings in our lives, quote unquote. It's not really a blessing, right? If it comes from the enemy, but things that God, the enemy will try to send into your life. So if it's from the enemy, a lot of times the number one characteristic is it will be very fast the way that it comes on. Okay, so if you notice that the devil took Jesus up and he said, I can give all of you this instantly. He took him up on that mountain. He showed it to him. He made it look very spectacular. It's almost like the devil, when he's tried to do this to me in my life in different areas, it's almost like this euphoria sets in. It's like you're just in this place of wow, you know, and it will seem like it's right in the moment, but really that's that distraction kicking in, right? And so it was fast. That's the number one thing. And it's not to say that God doesn't move fast, but we'll talk about the different way that God moves quickly in our lives in a second. Okay, so fast. Number two, a lot of times it will be really easy, quote unquote. Notice, you know, the devil said, Jesus, you can get all of this instantly if you want. He just straight up offered it to him. But there was a catch associated. You guys remember he said, if you bow down and worship me, if you surrender your authority, if you surrender your obedience in this area of your life, you're not going to have to wait. You're not going to have to go through a process. You're not going to have to do any of these things that God wants you to do to be prepared to sustain this thing down the line. You can just get it easy, quick, and it will be exactly what you're looking for kind of a thing in this moment, or you think it will be, right? And so a lot of times that's a characteristic of the devil, is it will feel very easy, right? Okay, you gotta be very careful. Okay, number three, we've already talked about this a little bit with the fast part, but I want to emphasize it in a different way, is it comes on quick and it provides instant gratification a lot of the time. Okay, and so this is definitely something that the devil likes to do. Notice with Jesus in the wilderness, you know, there was no process. There was nothing that, you know, God was trying to work through to prepare them to sustain. And this is what the devil does that causes us to fall in our lives a lot of the time. When the devil offers us a counterfeit blessing, yes, it's easy. Yes, our flesh loves that and we can walk right into it. But the problem is, without our character being built up, we're going to abort that promise, you know, a few years down the line a lot of the time, because we weren't prepared for it. Number one, it wasn't of God, so that in itself is going to cause issues. But number two, we're not even prepared to handle it a lot of the time when the devil offers it up. And so you've got to be very, very careful, because there is that instant gratification factor, and the devil will not talk to you about the fact that it comes with a catch down the line. He will only show you the good things behind that thing to try to trick you and to keep you distracted from the place of purpose. And remember, we already talked about how, you know, a lot of times the enemy will send this distraction, this counterfeit promise, into your life right before the real thing is about to hit. So you've got to be especially careful in seasons of warfare. Amen? Okay? So the fourth one is that it may be sent by the devil, is it often comes in the form of a distraction. It's sent to try to distract you from something bigger that God is trying to do in your life behind the scenes. And so we already talked about how distractions rarely look like distractions until they're done distracting you. So anytime you notice something that is distracting you from your walk with God and that is not leading you closer to God, you should start to get alarm bells going off in your brain. Okay? That's a big deal. All right? All right, number five, that it's sent by the devil. It will cause you to compromise up front a lot of the time to receive that blessing, even if it's small, okay? And so, for example, the devil said, if you will bow down and worship me. What that looks like in our society today a lot of the time is, if you will settle for my way over God's way in your life. All right, so compromise, right? So, you know, God, you know, the devil might show you, you know, that job that you've been really dreaming for, but that you're not prepared for and all this stuff. But he won't show you how you're going to abort it, you know, a couple years down the line. He won't show you the boss that's actually really bad, that he's making it look like it's all that up front, but he won't show you that you're actually going to be putting yourself into a really bad work environment. You know, relationships. The devil will show you that person who looks so perfect, and you just feel like you're on cloud nine when you're around them, and it comes on easy, and it comes on fast, and it satisfies everything that your flesh wants so much up front. But he won't tell you that you're going to be having sex before marriage a lot of the time, and you're going to fall into that sin. He won't tell you that that person is distracting you from your God assignment. He won't tell you, you know, that they're going to try to use you and manipulate you down the line. He won't show you that piece. He'll just show you the euphoric and the feel-good stuff up front. You guys following me today? So it will cause you to compromise up front a lot of the time, even if it is small. Okay. Number six sign that it could be sent from the enemy. The focus will always be on fulfilling the desires of your flesh rather than being spirit-led over your life. So what does flesh look like? flesh appeals to our senses a lot of the time, right? It appeals to what we can see, taste, touch, hear, smell, all of that fun stuff. And so I want you guys to notice what the devil did to Jesus in the wilderness. He gave him something very visual and put it smack dab in front of his face. And he said, look at what you could get if you bow down and worship me. Look at this. It's instant. Look at the glory. You notice that in scripture it used that word glory. He said, look at this in all of its glory. You could have this. And so your flesh can get really wound up when it's something that's sent by the enemy, all right? But again, the enemy doesn't tell you the destruction that will come down the line a lot of the time when you give into that. And you know, it's not to say that God doesn't want you to have good things in your life. He wants to activate that in a different way, but in a way better way that we're going to talk about down the line in a second, okay? Number seven, a sign that it could be sent from the enemy, is you will feel a lack of peace. And this is what this will look like. You can still have that euphoria feeling and really feel like you've got a connection to whatever it is that the devil's trying to present you with, but there will always be a kind of a nagging feeling in the back of your head. There will be a lack of peace on that thing. In other words, it feels like something is just not quite right, and you almost can't even put your finger on it a lot of the time. You know, sometimes it will be subtle. Sometimes it's all right, but sometimes it's subtle, you guys, and you've got to learn how to listen to your intuition and your gut, because Holy Spirit is talking to you a lot of the time, and he's trying to say, hey, this is the way. Walk in it. Don't go over there. Stay here. Stay grounded, okay? Number eight, sign that it could be sent from the enemy and not God over your life. It leads you farther away from God, or here's the kicker, a God gift is always, ladies and gentlemen, going to lead you closer to his presence. Sometimes a gift from Satan is not going to directly lead you off path, but it won't lead you closer to God, okay? That's also an alarm bell, you guys, because if it's not leading you closer to God, even if it looks like it's not doing any direct damage, it's still leading you away from God. Because in God's kingdom, there's only two options. You're either going away from God or closer to God. And numbness and not going either way, and in that middle ground, is going away from God. You guys following me today? Okay. All right, so that gift, quote unquote, that Satan tries to surrender to you will be a distraction. It will either lead you to not move forward or to move farther away from God, okay? And the ninth thing is it will be very flashy. Again, let's go back to what happened to Jesus in the wilderness when Satan tempted him. He showed him something that was, you know, super grand, right? He was showing him the kingdoms of the world and their glory, right? He took him up on a high mountain. It's almost like he was getting the quote-unquote prince treatment. He was getting this luxury experience with Satan if he would just give in and say yes, right? So the devil's flashy about stuff, you know, whereas God will try to bring it in and have the focus on the spirit first. The devil will try to get you to focus on the flesh first. That will be the appeal. That will be the draw to that particular quote-unquote blessing. And, you know, he won't tell you that there's a catch, but every single gift, quote-unquote, from Satan will always have a catch associated. And remember that the ultimate goal behind Satan giving you a quote-unquote gift is to get you in a place of compromise and to cause you to abort your purpose, and ultimately sometimes even to get you to turn away from God, you know, because if the devil, again, if he can get you to spend an eternity in hell, he doesn't mind you having something temporarily here, because it will mean almost nothing in the context of eternity. Okay. All right. So let's talk about what a God gift looks like when we receive something from the Lord over our lives. All right. A God gift, whether it's a new job, whether it's you know, a new relationship, whether it is, you know, a gift that you get, whatever this may be, you guys, a God gift will bring you spiritually closer to God first. Then the flesh is satisfied, okay? So God will connect you in the spirit first, and then that flesh part will come later, okay? And so it's not that God doesn't ever want you to experience good things or to have those desires met. He just wants there to be an order so that you won't abort it down the line, and so that it will be the very best thing that he has for you. Because you know what? God knows that when we put anything first in our lives other than him, for example, when we put flesh first instead of spirit first, that it's not a good gift for us. It will hurt us down the line. And so it will bring you, if it's a God gift, spiritually closer to God first. There will be alignment in the spirit first, and then that flesh part will get activated. God has an order. Amen. Number two, sign that it could be a gift from God is God's peace is on that situation. You know, it's not to say you won't ever encounter hard times, but it is to say that God's peace will be on that thing. Amen. You'll be drawn to it from a spiritual perspective first. Okay, so second thing is God's peace will be on it. Number three, and this is important, okay, that gift will often come after a process of preparation. In other words, it won't happen super fast up front. Now, let me clarify. God moves in suddenlies a lot of the time. So once your character is ready, once your spirit is ready, it is go time with God. You know, think of Joseph when he was promoted. You know, he went from the prison to the palace in 0.5 seconds once he interpreted that dream. But he went through a long preparation process to receive that gift from the Lord because God was preparing his character so that he could sustain the promise down the line. And so God promises in our lives may come suddenly, but they will almost always come after a process of preparation in our lives. Amen? So that's a very important one, okay? Number four. A God gift will never require you to compromise to receive that gift. And so the devil will always provide if, ands, or buts. And so he'll say, you know, you can receive this really big house if you accept this job in the porn industry, doing stuff that you know you should not be doing. I'll pay you hundreds of thousands of dollars if you will go set yourself up in an abortion place and work there. You know, there will always be some sort of compromise associated. You know, the devil will say, I will send you this person who believes in Jesus even, but the catch is, you know, they're going to require you to have sex before marriage. You know, and so there's always going to be some sort of a compromise, ladies and gentlemen, associated, okay? And so if it's a God gift, that's not going to happen, okay? And I'm not talking about, you know, compromise in terms of sometimes you have to be willing to give a little bit. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about having to compromise your right standing with God over a situation. Amen? Okay. And number five, sign that it could be a God gift in your life is it will not distract you from your walk with God. If anything, if God gives you a gift, it's going to lead you closer to his goodness. It's going to give him glory and it's going to glorify him. You know, just like the devil doesn't mind giving you houses, God wants you to have a good life too. What parent doesn't want their kids' needs to be met? But he wants it to be done correctly so that your focus is still on him first and not on the gift first. Amen. And so all of that to say, you guys, contrary to popular belief, the devil does like to give gifts to people, even to Christians. He loves to give gifts to Christians. If it will cause you to spend an eternity in hell or even just to surrender the purpose on your life, the devil will give you that job you've always wanted that'll cause you to go into compromise. He'll send that counterfeit spouse. He'll send that, you know, gift that you've been praying for forever in your life because he doesn't care. You know, if it causes you temporary distraction here but completely aborts the purpose and all the people whose lives you were supposed to touch and completely aborts the things that God had for your life for you to do while you were here, he doesn't care about that because he knows that he's got you for eternity. You know, he knows that he eternally thwarted your purpose behind that stuff. And so I just want to encourage you guys to be careful today. Pray about these things in your life and say, God, I want the God gift. I don't want that thing sent by the enemy, no matter how gratifying it seems to my flesh, no matter how tempting it is to settle in my life, God, I want it your way. Amen. Hope you guys have a great day. I'll talk to you soon.